Welcome, my dear student. Today I am again here to discuss the chapter coordination chemistry. In our last discussion, we have given some idea about the preliminary things of the coordination chemistry. Today my motto is to give you some idea about the names, that is IUPAC nomenclature of the coordination complex. Last day I have suggested you to go through the books for just to know the names and the charges of the different ligands. If you know the names and charges of the different ligands, then it will be very easy for you to write the names. I will just give you some hints about the laws, about the rules, how to use the rules to name a coordination complex. Let us take some examples. Let us take one example. For example, K4, then FeCN 6 times. So first rule is, you have to identify which part of the complex is positive and which part of the complex is negative. Here, this is the positive part and this is the negative part. That is, our coordination sphere is the negative part and the ionization sphere is the positive part. As per rule, if ionization sphere contains some numbers 3, 4, 2, 6, then we don't have to write the di, tri, tetra, penta, etc. Only just the name potassium. Sure. Then you have to start with the positive part. So here positive part is the potassium, then you write potassium. Okay. Then you write potassium, then you enter in the sphere part, coordination sphere part. Here we have the ligand CN, and we know CN is negative and it is known as cyano. So we have 6 CN, so it is hexacyano. Potassium hexacyano. Potassium hexacyano. Then the main thing is the metal atom. Here the metal atom in the sphere, which is negative sphere. So as per rule, you have to name the metal atom by adding ATE along with the name of the metal. So it will be ferrate, F-E-R-R-A-T-E, potassium hexacyano ferrate, F-E-R-R-A-T-E. Now the term is to calculate the oxidation number. The oxidation number is to be calculated. If you have some idea about the charge of the ligand, then let, we have to calculate the oxidation number of iron, let it be X. Now, we have potassium plus 1 into 4, that is 4 plus, and cyanide minus 1 into 6, that is 6 minus. 4 plus and 6 minus, if we cancel out, then we have minus 2. Since the complex is neutral, then it will be ultimately comes to plus 2. Then you have to write in the parenthesis immediately after the name, that is your Roman 2. So the full name will be potassium hexacyano ferrate 2. Next, let us take another example. The example is Na2SiF6. Na2SiF6. Again, this is the positive charge part and this is the negative charge part. Ionization sphere is positive, coordination sphere is negative. So we have to start with this positive part, and here the positive part is sodium. Sodium. Then F is known as fluorido. How many? 6. So it will be hexafluorido. F-L-U-O-R-I-D-O. Hexafluorido. Then it is silicon, but it will be named as silicate. Silicate. Sodium hexafluorido silicate. Now your duty to calculate the oxidation number of silicon. Let it be X. Let it be X again. If it is X, then sodium plus 1 into 2 and silicon minus 1 into 6 plus 2 minus 6. If they cancel out, then it will be minus 4. Since the complex is neutral, equal to 0, then it will automatically comes out to be, the value of X will be plus 4. So sodium hexafluorido silicate 4. Now the Second rule, if we like to explain the second rule, let us take another example. Cobalt NH3 six times, NH3 let it be five times Cl, third bracket close, 2+, 2+. Okay. Here the only sphere which is the coordination sphere and it is positive part. So we have to name this sphere only. Here two types of ligands are there. One is amino or A double M I N E, amine in our coordination complex, A double M I N E, amine, and it is chlorido. But alphabetically A comes first, then it will be first, and C comes second, then it will be in the second. So the name will be just pentaamine chlorido cobalt. Now it is cobalt because it is in the positive sphere, not cobalt 8. If it is in the negative sphere, then it will be cobalt 8. But it is in the positive sphere, it is in the positive sphere, so it is cobalt. One thing should be added, cobalt and its oxidation number will comes to automatically Roman 2 or Roman 3, anything, Roman 3, and it should be followed by one word, ion. So pentaamine chlorido cobalt 3 ion, because the complex is cationic form. Complex is in the cationic form. For example, another example, let it be potassium IR C2O4. Here C2O4 is the ligand which is known as oxalato. Oxalato. How many oxalato? Let it be 3. Then it is trioxalato. So the name will be potassium trioxalato, and it is in the negative sphere. It is in the negative sphere. So it is iridium converted to iridate. Iridium converted to iridate. Now if we calculate the charge, oxalato is minus 2 into 3, then it is minus 6, and potassium is plus 3. Minus 6 plus 3, if it cancel out, it will comes to minus 3, but since it is 0, then value of x will be plus 3. So the total name will be potassium trioxalato iridate 3. Next another example is Ni nickel CO 4 times. Ni CO 4 times. Here the metal is nickel, but the ligand is carbonyl. How many carbonyl? And this is actually neutral complex, so we have to name this complex only. Here how many carbonyl? 4. So it is tetracarbonyl. TetraCarbonyl, tetracarbonyl nickel, NICKEL. Now the oxidation number. The oxidation number, let it be X. Carbonyl is a neutral ligand. X plus 4 into 0 equal to 0, or X equal to 0. So it should be 0 in the bracket. So there are some coordination complex where the oxidation number may be 0 also. For example, this is one famous example. So if two or more ligands are there, then automatically competition will be on their name, starting with the alphabet. If two or more ligands, then you again go through the alphabetical order. The alphabet which comes first, it is to be written first. Now this is one famous example, CrEn thrice Cl3. So En, probably you have gone through book, and this is En, ethylene diamine. Now as per rule, if any ligand has its name di, tri, tetra, pentra,
are included in the name. Then, instead of di, tri, tetra, we have to use some another word. For example, instead of di, it will be bis. Instead of tri, it will be tris. And instead of tetra, it will be T-E-T-R-A-K-I-S, tetrakis, and so on. So, here, ethylene diamine, we cannot say tri ethylene diamine. Tris ethylene diamine. Tris ethylene diamine, chromium, and outside it is chloride. Because 3 Cl, not necessary to write the number 3, just only chloride. So, the name will be tris. Then, first bracket. Chromium within the parenthesis is oxidation number chloride. Here the oxidation number comes out to be 3. So tris ethylene diamine chromium 3 chloride. So these are different rules. For example, if we have some embidentate ligand in the coordination complex, then again we know how to name the embidentate ligand. For example, if it is CN, cyano, and if it is NC, isocyano. For example, if it is NO2, then it is nitro N. If it is ONO, then nitrito N, nitrito O. Similarly, we have SCN, thiocyanato S. If it is NCS, then it is thiocyanato N. Similarly, in this protocol, we have to name the coordination complex. So, we have so many different rules we have to follow. But if you like to follow the rules, your duty is to go through one by one name of the complex. You just write the formula of the complex and then write the name and match with the books. If it is okay, then sure, you have completed your knowledge. But if there is any problem, then again you learn. Then again you learn the rules. So it will be very nice if you go through the text only for naming the coordination complex. And one thing is there, if during any nomenclature, mainly if the oxidation number is not correct, then examiner will not provide you marks. As per my knowledge, examiner will not provide you marks. Only it may be half or 1 foot mark may be given to you, but it is at most important to write the oxidation number very nicely and correctly. Secondly, during the names of the ligands, you have to follow the spelling of the ligands, spelling of the metal, etc. And one thing, if there is any positive or negative charge, then you must write ion after the name. So, in this way, you have to make practice about the rules and regulations of IUPAC norms for coordination complex. So, this is all about the coordination complex nomenclature. Because time is very short, I cannot cover up in a short time. In your physical class, when I will meet with you, I will again give you some detailed discussion. If any problem is there, you please make contact with me. I will like to solve you. And in our next discussion, we will try to explain the bonding in coordination complex. This is one of the most important part of this coordination chemistry, because bonding is the main thing. And in the very beginning of this chapter, I have said the bonding is nothing but coordinate covalent bond. But how the coordinate covalent bond takes place? What are the different approaches? So basically, we will follow two different approach. One is valence bond theory and another is crystal field theory. So in our next discussion, I start valence bond theory and then crystal field theory. And one thing is more important for this chapter, this is isomerism in coordination complex. This is very nice also, isomerism in coordination complex. I hope you will get some interest in isomerism and bonding. And surely you can practice. If you practice in your home, you can make easily the knowledge of coordination chemistry. So for the next class, today I like to conclude here. In the next class, I will start again from valence ball theory and piston field theory of coordination chemistry. Goodbye.